Are you looking forward to the film tonight?
Yeah, very much so, actually. I've heard some really nice things about it. Had a little read-up as well about, you know, this sounds like an interesting premise. It reminds me of movies like Whistle Down the Wind, you know, that kind of idea, this unusual kind of relationship between two people and how that plays out. So, yeah, looking forward to it a lot. With events like Raindance, and especially when it comes to supporting independent cinema, I think it's really crucial. It's a hard industry to crack anyway, and budgets are hard to find in our industry. I think with someone like Nathaniel going out and doing a movie like this, I think it's incredibly important to sort of tell stories and find new artists and new creatives in the industry. So amazing that Raindance is supporting it. I support British film. I'm really passionate about British film and trying to sort of help spur it on. I think it's not enough that we kind of just get along and see events like this. You know, it's important also, you know, to put your hand in your pocket and go and see films and support it. It's a lot of talk at the moment about trying to reshape the industry and try and move things forward in a different way. It's all about us as audience members as well. And I think that's up to people like myself and other people that would normally go and see this kind of movie, really try and be discerning with what you watch and go and see independent films. I recently finished a foreign language movie, actually. It was a Russian movie, which is quite interesting. I was playing an American in that. As you know, at the top of the year, we've been sort of doing a lot of publicity for Amar Akbar and Tony, which had a cinema release. And I think the last time we'd spoken, I think it was just about opening up. And it's been really interesting how that's gone. You know, we were up against Avengers and stuff. You know, you're only guaranteed like a week in the cinema with this kind of thing. And we managed to stick around in places like Birmingham and London for like 5 weeks, which was incredible. So that was really nice. We're doing a VOD launch on November the 2nd. So iTunes, places like that, Amazon, you know, you're going to be able to get Amar Akbar and Tony and watch it on your laptop or watch it on your smartphone or whatever. So really looking forward to the release of that. And then I'm building up some publicity for a couple of movies that are coming out next year. Now You See Me, the second act, and also Bonded by Blood 2. So it's quite a busy time. It's good fun. And Amar Akbar and Tony is a British Asian film. But it's a true representation of what British Asian life is like in West London. I think the sort of premise behind it, or the idea behind it for Atul Malhotra, the writer-director, was to really give people that kind of accurate view. You know, it's a multicultural society we live in, and for the most part, people get on really, really well. And that was a real celebration of that life. Myself playing Tony was a sort of token white guy in the movie, and a comedy character, really. So it was a lot of fun. It was a real lot of fun of a movie, and some great performances in it. Mira Sayal, Nina Wadia cropping up, doing a marvellous job, and great sort of supporting leads as well, from Amrita Acharya, Goldie Nate, Karen David, and Laura Aikman as well. Just fantastic. It's a lot of fun, and I think it's got a bit of something for everyone, really. So what we do well in England, which is sort of make people laugh, hopefully.